Skaeth's Wild Hunt are elf-like creatures. This deadly and flexible warband are capable of cutting down the enemy at range as well as at close quarters. In this video, we're going to share how to paint Skaeth the Huntsman. However, by following this paint guide, you'll easily be able to paint any other member of the warband. So grab those brushes, shake those paints, and let's get started. Before we begin painting, the first thing we'll need to do is undercoat the model. And as you can see here, I've used Wraithbone, which is perfect for all the colours we're going to be using in this video. Now we're going to start with the skin, and for this we'll be using Gulliman Flesh, thinned down with contrast medium. So I'm just going to give the pot a quick shake, like so, then I'll pop it open. Now I always like to apply the actual medium first so I don't end up contaminating the pot. So I'm just going to get my brush, and I'm going to add about 3 dollops of contrast medium to my palette, and then just one paintbrush of Gulliman Flesh. And I'm just going to mix that in like so, get my brush to a nice point, and then we're ready to start applying that to the model. So all I'm going to do is then just start applying that to his skin. So all I need to do is just start moving that around like so. Now don't worry if you get this on other areas, because we can always tidy back up with Wraithbone after. There we are with the Gulliman Flesh now applied and dry, we're ready for the next step. And for this we're going to be using Flayed On Flesh. I'm going to layer some of those raised areas on his skin. So the first thing I'm going to do is just apply a little bit to my palette like so. Tiny little touch of water as well, just to make it a little bit smoother. To get our brush to a nice point, like so, and then we're ready to start layering that up. So all I'm aiming to do here is just, like I say, pick out those raised areas, basically where like his muscles are, and then just coat them over with some Flayed On Flesh. We're trying to avoid getting to the recesses so you can see that Gulliman Flesh. This will add some nice definition to the model. With the skin now layered up, we're going to move on to the highlight. For this, we'll be using Screaming Skull. So I'm going to be using a small layer brush for this just to get a nice point. So all I'm going to do is just apply a little bit to the palette like so. Again, another little touch of water as well. Get a nice point to that brush, and we're ready to start highlighting. So what we're aiming to do here is just to pick out those edges like so. And what this will do is just give us some more definition, because you've got that Gulliman Flesh in those recesses. There we are, with the skin now highlighted, we're going to move on to the next step, which is to start painting the fur parts of the beast. So for this, we're going to start with Mournfang Brown. We'll be using a medium layer brush for this as well. So I'm just going to apply a little bit to the palette, a little bit more than that, a little touch of water. And once we've got our brush nicely loaded up, we're ready to start base coating. Now I'll probably want to do a couple of thin coats of this, because obviously you've got quite a light undercoat there. So just work your way around the actual beast itself. And if you can, just avoid painting the hooves, because you want to leave those as Wraithbone. There we are, with all the fur now base coated, we're going to move on to the next step, which is to apply a shade. And for this, I'm going to be using Agrax Earthshade. So I'm going to continue using my medium layer brush for this. Just going to apply a little bit to the palette like so. Try not to overlay my brush too much, and then we're ready to start coating that fur. So the key thing here is to coat all over the actual fur and pay special attention to those deeper recesses. With the shade now applied and dry, we're ready to move on to doing some highlighting. I'm going to start by using Scrag Brown. So I'm going to continue using my small layer brush and apply a little bit to the palette again. Again, another touch of water. Key here is to get your brush to a real nice sharp point. So you just need to give it a couple of spins like so on the palette. Then we're ready to start highlighting. Now what we're aiming to do here is just to pick out some of that muscle tone. So just looking for those raised areas like so. Just to get some nice definition. And also at the very base of his hooves, or the socks if you like, on the actual hooves, you want to actually probably more layer that on like so. So probably just a little bit way up to the ankle. There we are, with that highlight now done on the beast fur, we're ready to move on to the final highlight. And for this, we're going to be using Deathclaw Brown. So as we did in the previous one, we're just going to apply a little bit to the palette like so, with a little touch of water. Get our brush to a nice point, and then we're ready to start highlighting. Now what we're aiming to do here is actually get this highlight actually into the center of those previous highlights we've just done. So it just needs to be a bit finer, and just take your time. When you get to the bottom where his hooves are, you just want to highlight those bits up as well where the fur is. And there we are, with the beast fur now done, we're going to move on to the next detail, which is to paint the hooves. Now it's worth just tidying up with Wraithbone if you made any splodges on the hooves. The colours I'm going to be using, we're going to start with Agrax Earthshade, and then we're going to highlight using Screaming Skull. So first of all, let's get some Agrax Earthshade onto the palette, get a nice point to the brush, then we're just going to apply that all over those hooves. So you don't have to be too neat at this point, all you need to do is just coat over the Wraithbone entirely, like so. There's also just a little bit on his tail to do as well. We'll be doing this the exact same colour. With the Agrax Earthshade now dry, we're going to start highlighting the hooves using Screaming Skull. What we're aiming to do here is just like little vertical lines, just to give the sense of like bone and hoof. With the hooves now done, we're going to move on to the next step, which is to paint his hair. We're going to start with Jacare Orange. We're then going to use Griffhound Orange after that. We'll apply that a couple of times just to add some depth. And we'll finish off with a highlight of Fire Dragon Bright. But first of all, let's start applying that base coat. So I'm just going to apply a little bit to my palette. Again, some more water. And we're ready to start base coating that onto the actual hair. Now, you probably want to do a couple of coats here just so you avoid any of that wraith bone showing through. Just take your time. If you do make any mistakes on those other areas you painted, just tidy back up. With the base coat on the hair now done, we're going to apply our first coat of Griffhound Orange, and we're going to apply this all over the hair. With our first coat of Griffhound Orange now applied, we're going to apply a second coat. We're just going to keep it to the tips of the hair. Let's just make it a little bit darker, just give it a bit more definition on those edges. With the contrast on the hair now dry, we're going to start highlighting, and for this we're using Fire Dragon Bright. What we're aiming to do here is just start at the base of the hair and just move our brush upwards to pick up those strands. Now in some places you can use the edge of the brush around near the top parts of the hair like so. For the most part you would need to use the tip, so just be careful if you do make any mistakes, just tidy back up with some Griffhound Orange. And there we are, with the hair now done, we're going to move on to painting the black leather. For this we're going to be using Black Templar, and in some cases where in the deeper recess we'll apply a second coat of Black Templar, and then we'll highlight with Dawnstone. So first of all, let's start that first coat. So I'm just going to apply a little bit onto the palette. Again, this is just to get a nice point to my brush, especially when we're going around some of those details we've already painted. So once we've got a nice point, we'll start picking out that leather. So I'll start on his actual harness around his waist just here. So one coat should be sufficient, but like I said, if you do need to add a second one, just run that in the deeper recesses. And don't forget to do his horns as well. There we are, with the leather and horns now done, I did apply a second coat of Black Templar to that leather just for a little bit more definition, and you'll also notice on his armour, remove the shield just to access that vambrace. So what I'm going to do now is start highlighting with Dawnstone. So all you're aiming to do here is just pick out those edges and just take your time, and if you do make any splodges, just run a little bit of Black Templar over it, and that should help hide it. There we are, with the black now done, we're going to move on to painting the gold details. We're going to start by base coating with Retributor Armour, then we're going to shade with Agrax Earthshade. So first of all, let's start with that base coat. As always, just get some on your palette, a little touch of water, let's get a nice point, and then we'll start picking out those gold details. Now there's quite a few on this model now, so we've got his actual javelin to do, there's his helmet, all the trim around his armour, and he also got some little beads in his hair as well to do. With all those gold details now base coated, we're going to shade them with Agrax Earthshade. So just take your time. If you do find it pulling those recesses, just soak them up with your brush. There we are, with the golds now shaded, we're going to move on to the next step, which is to paint the trim and the helmet. And to give it that nice forested green gold kind of look that you see on the box art, we're going to be using Mortarian Green Clear. And then when that's done, we're going to highlight all the gold using Stormhost Silver. So first of all, let's get some of that Mortarian Green. So I'm just going to apply a little bit onto the palette, just to get my brush to a nice point, and then we're going to start coating this over the gold. Now it's just best to do one coat to start off with, but if you want a bit more depth, you can always add a second coat once that's dry. So all I'm going to do is, like I said, on the trim and the helmet, is just coat this over. You'll start to see that metallic still showing through, but it gives it a nice greeny tone to it. With the Mortarian Green now applied and dry, we're going to start highlighting all the gold using Stormhost Silver. So where possible, just use your edge of your brush like so, and in some places, just use your point. And when you do that, just be extra careful. There we are, with the gold now highlighted, we're going to move on to the next area, which is to paint the spear tip. And for this, we're going to start with Iron Hand Steel, then going to shade with Northern Oil and finish off with a highlight of Stormhost Silver. So first of all, let's start that base coat. So I'm just going to apply a little bit to the palette. Again, just a slight touch of water. I'll brush to a nice point and then we're ready. So all I'm going to do is just coat that spear tip. You might want to do a couple of coats because some of that wraith bone might start to show through. So just take your time, coat over. With the spear tip now base coated, we're going to shade all over using Norn Oil. With the shade now dry, we're going to highlight with Stormhost Silver. So all we're aiming to do here is just use the edge of the brush just to pick out the edge of the blade like so. We want to do this on both sides. There we are with the spear tip now done. We're going to move on to the next area, which is to paint his red weave armour. Now for this, we're going to start with a base coat of corn red. We're then going to apply flesh tear as red all over that. After this, we're going to highlight with Wazadaka red. Then we'll follow up with a highlight of Cadian flesh tone. And finally, we're going to use a little bit of black temper just to line in around the edges for some definition. So first of all, let's start with that corn red. So again, as always, just apply a little bit to the palette and a little touch of water. Get our brush to a nice point. And then we'll start painting those areas. Now there's a few bits of armour to pick out, and this will vary from model to model, but if you're unsure, just check the box art for details. With the corn red now dry, we're going to start applying flesh terror red to all this red weave armour. Just take your time, and if you do make any mistakes, just tidy back up. With the flesh terror red now dry, what we're going to do is start highlighting with Wazadaka red. Now what we're aiming to do here is do little strokes like so, and we're following the same direction as the pattern. So you probably want three little strokes per section. What you'll get here is the same impression as like a weave. So you want to do this on all those areas. Take your time, if you make any mistakes, just tidy back up. With that first highlight now done, we're going to use Cadian flesh tone and do the exact same thing, but we're highlighting a little bit thinner than the first time. So just follow the same contours as the last one. And if you make any mistakes, just tidy back up. With the highlights on the red weave armour now done, we're just going to use a little bit of black temper just to go around the edges, just to line in. This will just help give a little bit of definition and really make the armour pop out. There we are with the red weave armour now done. We're going to move on to the final detail, which is to paint the glowy gems. Now there's one on his belly, there's one on his helmet, and one on his saddle. So we're going to start by using Korax White as a base coat. We're then going to use more Taurian Green Clear over that. Then we'll finish off with just a little bit of a highlight of Korax White again. So first of all, let's get that Korax White done. So again, just a little dollop or two. It's on my palette, tiny touch of water, and we're ready to start painting those gems. So I'll start with the one on the belly first, so you can see just inside of his stomach just there. So all you need to do is just go in gently and just pick that out. There's gonna be one on his helmet at the very top as well to do, just up here, and then one on his right side of the saddle, which is just here. With them gems now base coated, we're going to apply more Taurian Green Clear. Now on the one on his belly, what I'm going to do is first of all apply actually onto the actual gem, and then just around the surrounding area a little bit, just to give the impression of a bit of a glow. And on the rest, we're just going to coat straight over. There we are with the Taurian Green Clear now applied. We're just going to do a couple of little dots just on those gems just to add a little bit more brightness just to the top area like so. So just a little dot here, a little dot there, and then just one on his belly as well. And with that done, don't forget to base your model. With the model now painted and based, they're ready to head off into the beast grave to seek fame and glory. Now there are a couple of things to remember when painting this model. Firstly, when doing any highlighting, use the smallest brush possible and also keep it to a nice sharp point as well. If you're using any shades or contrasts, try not to overload your brush as it can quickly run out of control. If you do find this happening, just use your brush to soak up any excess. And also remember when using metallic paints, change your water regularly as well, because otherwise you'll start to get metallic flecks mixed in with other colours. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Hope you enjoy painting your own Beast Grave Warband, and we'll see you again soon. Bye bye.